Grace and peace to you today. I hope that you and your family are all doing okay and that you are making the best of these days. I hope that you are enjoying the goodness of God. Hope that you are enjoying your family. Hope that you are enjoying life as best you can in spite of our circumstances. I hope that you are continuing to stay safe and stay well in body, mind, and spirit. And if, like me, every now and again you feel overwhelmed by all that's happening around us, know that that's okay. Stop, take a deep breath, and stay in God's peace. And remind yourself that God is with you and that He will see us through one day at a time. Well, here we are in the month of November. Can you believe it? We are heading towards the end of 2020. What a year this has been. A year filled with so much uncertainty. A year filled with many disappointments and setbacks. A year filled with ups and downs. A year filled with so much loss. And yet, we can look back over the 8-9 months and still have a heart of thankfulness to God for seeing us through to this point in time. In spite of all the challenges that are behind us, in spite of the uncertainty that is in front of us, we can have an attitude of gratitude. We can still be thankful to God. Thankful not for the pandemic, but thankful that even in the midst of the pandemic, He is with us and He is walking with us every step of the way. There's a verse from 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18, which reminds us and encourages us to be thankful. It says, "In everything give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you." I love the Message translation of this verse. And it says this: "Thank God no matter what happens. This is the way God wants you who belong to Christ Jesus to live." Can I say that again? Thank God no matter what happens. This is the way God wants you who belong to Christ Jesus to live. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. I thank God for you. And I thank God that over the last 7 weeks, we were able to participate in the 40 Days of Purpose Bible Discovery series. There were 5 Zoom groups that met over the 7-week period, and 80 persons participated in those groups. And it was a wonderful time of Bible study, a time of fellowship, time of learning, sharing, and a time of praying. While that Bible study series has come to an end, our Zoom groups will continue. And if you haven't already done so, we want to encourage you to join a group. We will be continuing with some pre-Advent Bible studies. And then beginning in the new year, we will begin a new series. We hope that you'll join us for a wonderful time of discovery, of learning God's word, of sharing with each other, and a time of fellowship. At the end of our 40 Days of Purpose Bible Discovery series, we had a party. It was a Zoom party, but a party nonetheless, because it was a wonderful time of laughter and fun and sharing, a wonderful time of reflection. Someone said to me at the end of the Zoom party that the only thing missing was the cake and ice cream. Well, here are some highlights from our Zoom party a time of celebration and giving thanks.
Pumpkin, panther, peacock, piranha, platypus, porpoise, pony, palm, pear, posy, pineapple, poison ivy, peach, potato, pig, porcupine, pine, poinsettia.
I love to discipleship. I love to teach about him. I love to decide.
Very creative.
Try.
At least you try.
We gon' celebrate and have a good time.
From the series, the word which I would stand so for me is purpose. I discovered that God created me to fulfill his purposes through me. And so as a Christian, God expects me to do everything to glorify him through worship. He expects me to be his family in fellowship. And I am expected to become like Christ through discipleship. I am expected to serve God in ministry and conduct mission through evangelism. These purposes will last throughout eternity.
I always considered fellowship as a time when you spend together in church or at a Christian function, followed by eats and socializing. I always thought that is what fellowship was all about. Through studying the book, Purpose Driven Life, Session 3, it talks about fellowship, and I discovered that fellowship is much more than what I was thinking it was. Fellowship is thinking less of myself and more of others. God commanded us to love one another because we are one family.
Church is ministry. From the series, I learned that ministry is not just the various organizations within the church, but the focus is a lot on our gifts and understanding that all of us have different gifts, and we should use whatever gift we have to serve others, and that no gift is too small.
My word is service. The reason I chose the word service is because I felt like the book and the video lessons, a lot of them actually connected to service. In the chapter on fellowship, we were reminded on the fourth level of fellowship is fellowshipping together. In the chapter on ministry, we learn about the four ways in which we could serve like Jesus and how we are shaped for service. And in the chapter on worship, we learned about using our abilities for God.
The word I chose was purpose. And it's because God has a purpose and a plan for each of our lives. And even though there are billions of persons in the world, God has a plan for each of our lives, which was ordained even before we were born. And it just confirms that we are not here by accident, but we have a certain purpose that God wants us to do.
We were shaped to serve our master, that is a ministry. Evangelism is our mission to spread the gospel.
We gonna celebrate and have a good time.
Party over now. Go home, everybody.
Really?